Hey, and welcome to another video. So today we are on our IP intercom video series still, and now we're getting to quite an interesting video, and we're going to be setting up a card for breeder module. Okay, we're going to attach this to our existing name tag module and door station, and now you'll be able to access the door just through the fob or your a smart card. Okay, so it's a standard setup that we've been doing in the last few videos. So we've got one station and we have three separate flats. Okay, but this video is going to be a little bit different from the other ones if you've been watching them, because we're going to actually add people to the system. So on IVMS, you can actually add groups of people, individuals, and then that's how we're going to assign the keypads from them. Okay, not the keypads, the fobs and the smart cards. Alright, so we're going to quickly show you the items and the setup live in person in a second. And then we're going to flip back to IVMS and show you how to configure the setup. And then we'll show you the actual fobs and cards in live in action towards the end of the video when it's all set up. Alright, so bear with us and we're going to show you the stuff now. Okay, so this is our setup we're using. We've got our PoE switch here, our yellow cable's connected to the internet, three screens plugged in, and we have the green cable connected to our main door station. So this is our main door station, and below it we have our name tag reader, and we have our new unit here, which is our card fob reader. Okay, so what we did have to do though is change the dip switch settings on here. So let me show you quickly at the back here. You've got a little dip switch. Okay, if this rubber comes off, there we go. Okay, and because it's the third unit, all we have to do is put number one and two up to represent this is the third unit. Okay, so it does come in the instructions how to set this dip switch. It's very easy, but if it's not working your unit, then don't forget to check that out. Okay, so we've got our doorbell out here with our card reader, and here's our fobs we'll be using. So we've got just a basic Hikvision fob. Okay, and we have smart cards as well. So let me show you a smart card. Okay, they both do the same job, just in different formats. So this is our setup we've got. Okay, just quickly test it out.
Calling failed.
Calling failed. Okay.
Calling failed.
Let's try the fob. Okay, beep beep, nothing's happening. Card. Nothing happened. It's just a door open, so we're going to flip over now to IVMS and show you how to get that to work. See you in a sec. Okay, so now we're back onto IVMS. And as previous videos, all we've done is activated our devices and enabled DHCP and added them to the main area. Okay, so just check out our previous videos. There's a link below how to do that. But we've done no settings at all apart from the basic initialization. So let's quickly set up the units and then we're going to add people and access control to our system. Okay, so it's a little bit different setup this time. Let's quickly get this configured and then we'll show you how to add the card readers and the fobs and everything like that. Okay, so as usual, we set the door station. Okay, we go intercom, put in our password. Okay, so we set up flat one. Network. So room one means flat one, password, IP address. Okay, so that's flat one done. Okay, so we'll repeat that again for flat two and three. Okay, just rushing through this a little bit, guys, because we've already done this in previous videos. So if you're not too sure, I advise you check them out. Save that. That's flat two done. Now we go to flat three. And then network. Room three. Password and IP address. Again. Okay, so that's our three flats done. Remember, we now set up our door station. So we go to intercom and then our sub module configuration. So you see now we've got the card reader module added and we've got the name tag module added as well. But the press button to call on our sub module, we just want 1:1, 2:2, 3:3, etc. Okay, so button number one will now call flat number one. Okay, so as you see now we've got three flats set up and the door station all ready to go. So now we're going to add the people and the cards. So we go to our main menu, we go to person. Okay, so we can call this, so we could call it Larry's flats. These are my flats, pretend I own them. If I can spell flats. Okay, and then we're going to add a person. Okay, so we've got the person ID number one, we'll keep that the same. Call this person, say John. Okay, we've got the email, telephone, you can enter that in yourself obviously, but we're not going to be doing that. So this is an important part. We got the card here. You can enter in fingerprints, that's that you need a different unit for that, but this is how you enter it in, but we're going to be entering a card. Okay, so we go here, and this card type is just a normal card. We go settings. So it will come as default local, but we don't want local, we want card reader. So we go device, and it'll be on our door station. Okay, so we go to read, and then what you do is, it's looking for the fob. So you go to your card reader fob, and your card reader and hold the fob next to it. Let's see if this works. There we go. So you heard a beep and it's read the number and then it's added the number into the software and then we go to add. And now it's added a card here, a fob. So now we're gonna add another one. We're gonna add a card. It's done exactly the same process, but we're gonna use a card instead. So let me do that now. Okay, so that's added the card. So we go add. And now user one, John, has got two forms of access now. He's got a fob and a card. So now let's just finish setting this up. It goes access group. Okay, no, we don't need that. Don't need the PIN number, don't need the access. Resident information. Okay, bind device. So obviously this is John is in flat one. We put in flat one. Room number one. 1:1. Okay. Then we got additional information. Okay, we don't need that. Just more information about. But this is an important part, binding in the device. Okay. So we go add. So now that John is added and he's got two cards as it says. So let's quickly add two more people. So we call this person Sandra. And female. Okay. And we're gonna add another card and another fob. Okay, we'll go read. Okay, so we add that. We're gonna add another one. Okay, add. And then we go down to resident information and we're going to bind device number two. And this is floor number, I think it would go, we put floor number two, room number one. No, I would go room number one, floor number two. I think that should work. We'll double check that in a minute. And where you do make mistakes sometimes, it's good to make mistakes so you learn. And we'll put this person down as Susie. Okay, female. And we're going to add another card and fob. Okay, add that. And we'll add another last card. Okay, and this is user number for flat three, so we just go resident information, bind device, flat three, floor number one, room number three. Okay, and we go add. Okay, so we've got three users now, and we have our station set up. Well, one more last step. So we have to go to access control here. Okay, access control, and then we go to authorization, access group on the left. Okay, so I need to give this group authorization, basically. It's a quick setup. So we go Larry's flat. Household. Okay, so they got all day authorization. Okay, or you can deny them. They're quite good. And we go our flat, and we've added now John, Sandra, and Susie. And we select the access point, which is, see the little arrow here? That means it kind of tells you which one to go for. So we go here, and we set the door station, and we go save. Okay, now, don't forget to apply it. We have to go apply here to all, apply all to device. And it's quite handy here. If you do have an error or something not working, it's going to tell you. But no, it's gone green, all applied. So that's great. So it's all set up now. So we've made our devices, added our people, added our fobs and cars, and we've made a control group, and we've applied that to the unit. All right, so we're going to flip over now to our live view and test it all out. Okay, so this is our setup now configured and complete. Let's test it out quickly. So we've got our three flats, number one. Okay, ring in. Number two. Okay, number two, all good, ring in. Number three. Okay, that's all configured nicely. And we have our, look over here, we've got our three sets of fobs. Okay, so let's quickly test these out.
The door is open.
The door is open, okay.
The door
is open. Alright, great, so they're very easy to set up, these fobs. And what we're going to be doing, show you in a video later, is how to use the software a little bit better. So obviously, if your client might want to add new users and things like that, you have to use IVMS. There's no client software for the client. So what we recommend is give them our video we're going to be doing later. Simple as that. So we're going to show you a video how to set up the fobs, how to add users, delete users, and we're also going to show you the log. So obviously, we go here. The open door, and you might want to see the log of who done this or what time and all the details like that. It's coming up in a future video, so don't worry, we've got the complete guide here. So hopefully now you can you're not too scared of using fobs and access cards. They're pretty straightforward, and yeah, and check out our other videos coming up, and it's the full spectrum of how to use the software. So see you guys soon, and hope you enjoyed that, and thanks, bye bye.